crafty friends, welcome in my next video for Altenew. Today I am working with Altenew, new release from May. I will be using stamps and dies, and I'm starting with this amazing set called Ornate Foliage. I am not sure how to pronounce it. There are some, I would say, a little bit retro flowers, like ornaments and stamps that can help you fill them with colors. It's not a typical layered stamp, as you do not layer color on color, but you layer color next to color, and you can choose the colors you want, so the flower doesn't have to be in one color with different shades. I created a pink and yellow combination and blue and purple one. So I started with stamping the outlines. There are two stamps in this set, two flower clusters, and I use archival ink for this one. And now I'm going to stamp the colors. Everything is described in the leaflet that is included into the stamp set, so you will know exactly where to stamp each part. And I started with the yellow. I created I grouped the layers of the same color and I glued them down to the acrylic block, and now I just stamp the same on all of my prepared outlines. I will have like I think 10 of each design, or maybe 8 of each design, and 4 of them will be yellow pink and 4 of them will be blue and purple. So I'm just switching the colors. I decided to use just an acrylic block, not a stamping platform, because I thought it will be faster for me than to use it. I'm not sure if it was, but I like doing these repetitive things because it's relaxing to me, and it's good when I do not have a mojo. So I just sit, I stamp, and I create elements for the layout, and then when I feel I already have a good idea, I sit down and I just use the elements I already have. This is what I do with fussy cutting too. So I like to fussy cut when I have time to scrapbook, but I do not have, you know, a particular idea for the layout. I just sit and fussy cut or stamp, and then I have ready elements to use them on my projects. And as you can see, there are a lot of tiny elements in this set, and you have to place them well. But when I already have them placed, I glue them to one acrylic block, and I didn't have to stamp each tiny element separately. I'm stamping them all at once. But you have to remember to pick the ones in similar colors, or if you are covering the stamp with ink, use different shades on one acrylic block. If you have a new stamps like I do, remember about rubbing them with a clean cloth or a rubber to make them less shiny, I would say. And then the ink won't group into the puddles. It will stay on the whole surface of the stamp. And now I'm adding the element that I wasn't able to incorporate in the acrylic block because it was too close to the previous one. And now I'm switching colors. I will do the same with the yellow flowers. First, I'm dealing only with the bigger cluster, and then I will do exactly the same with the flowers in a smaller cluster. And I am almost done. And I'm stamping leaves right now because those flowers also have colorful leaves. I am using Altenew mini ink cubes. Maybe it would be faster if I would have a bigger inks, but on the other hand, I do not stamp that much that I could justify buying oval inks, because I just do it from time to time, and I'm afraid that I wouldn't be able to use them properly, give them a justice. So I prefer ink cubes because I can buy more colors for the same money. And if I would be a card maker who stamps a lot, I would definitely invest in bigger pads, because the bigger pads are more convenient if you stamp a lot. And here are all my flowers. Now I need to cut them out. Luckily, I have a matching die for this set, so it will take me only a few minutes. I need to use my bigger machine, although I really like using the small Altenew one because it's more handy, but the stamps are just too big and they won't fit into the mouth of this machine. I'm using a washi tape to hold the die in the right spot, and I'm just cutting the same elements 8 or 10 times. I'm not sure how many I had of them, and it's a really fast process, especially with the dies that has some corners and stuff like that are not that easy to cut, like a simple flower shape, because when it comes to simple flower shapes, I sometimes prefer fussy cut them on hand, by hand. And now I will be using this Walk in the Woods stamp. It's a stamp set because it's a big background and some inscriptions, but I will only use the background. I picked four cardstock colors: pink, yellow, teal, and purple, and I will stamp the same thing 4 times. And it was a new stamp, so I needed to wipe it to make it adhere the color better. And this is the disadvantage of having a small ink cubes. I had to ink the stamp many times to get a good impression, because always I had some spot not covered with ink, and the ink was light, so it was hard to see if it's covered well. But I changed the color to the darker pink and it went much better, and I stamped like a first half first and the second half later. But I have a stamping platform, so I can easily repeat the stamping as many times as I want to get a good effect. And I will do the same with 3 other colors. I just changed the ink colors, so it's a color on color, slightly darker than the color I have for the background. And now I'm trimming down all my squares to the smaller sizes. I will create kind of a grid design. Maybe it's not a grid design in designing, but it looks like a grid with 4 colors of background. And now I'm creating squares of a cardboard that will be glued under the pieces of cardstock to add a little bit of dimension. And I am using just regular glue to adhere them. And this is the glue like you really like, the ones from Tonic or Anita's, but it's a Polish glue. It has a metal tube, which is not good because it sometimes breaks and it makes your hands dirty, but the quality of the glue is the same. So if you would like to ask what glue I am using Polish glue, which is basically the same as the Tonic glue or Anita's glue. I glued down all my 4 colors, and as you can see, I rotated 2 of the patterns. This stamp cannot be repeated. I don't know if I am saying it well, but you cannot continue it creating a bigger pattern, because if I would, I would definitely use it that way and create one big wood pattern on my layout. I added a purple frame around my picture, and now I am adding my flowers, trying to arrange them in some composition, and after I will be happy how it looks, I will be able to glue things down. And I had idea for this layout in my head when I saw the new stamps and I could pick some. I already had an idea for this layout, so I am happy I could work with those. I really like them, and I think they would look amazing in a more pastel shades, like a very, very pale flowers on the background too. I am using 3D foam squares to adhere the flowers to the background, and I hope I cut it out where I am. No, I didn't, so you will see me doing it. But I used a 3D foam squares to add a little bit of more of dimension, so each flower is a little bit raised over the surface of the colorful blocks. I think I forgot, or maybe it didn't record it. Record the last part of this process where I was embellishing the page after my flowers were glued down. I used some ribbons from Paige Evans collections, and I wrapped them between the flowers. I thought it would be a good way to finally put them into use before they will lose the stiffness, because as you know, or maybe you do not know, so you will learn it now. You don't want your ribbons to be saved forever. Use them right away, because otherwise they will lose the stickiness of them, and you won't be able to wrap them to the background anymore, especially the gold ones. This is something I learned a few times, that the gold ribbons do not wrap very fastly. So I had them for a half a year, I think, and they lost their stickiness. So I wrapped some of the smaller elements from Paige Evans ribbons. They are from Pick It Up and Whimsical collections. And I didn't record it, so I'm telling you about this right now. I also added few puffy shapes like hearts to the background. So I didn't add much. I also added a title. The title is Happiness, and it was created by Pinkfresh Studio Puffy Words from one of their new collections. I also added a tiny puffy stickers I had in my stash from various American crafts collections. So you didn't lose a lot of of my process. I don't know what happened, but it happened and I couldn't undo it. So there is the final pictures. There are the final pictures of my page. I hope you like it. Check the description box for the links, and don't forget to visit my blog to join the blog hop and win some awesome prizes. Thank you for stopping by, and see you soon. Bye bye.